Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, you're welcome. If you're not a subscriber, welcome back. Today I'm going to be sharing with you how to make a crinoline spiral headband, a crinoline spiral fascinator. I'm just going to be showing you the technique required in making a crinoline spiral. So I have with me my crinoline UHU glue, scissors, needle and thread, flexible wire. This is a jerry wire of 0.50 millimeters. So I have my bias strip, I have this is a rose flower to embellish with. I have headband covered already with fabric, it's the tiny one. Now for me, I'm going to be using a length of crinoline of about 25 inches and that is what I just cut out. The width of this my crinoline is about 7 inches. There's this kind of thread we have on one side of crinoline, you can decide to take it off if you want to. You can leave it if you want to. So I'm going to be using my UHU glue to secure the ends of one side of my crinoline together like this. I just apply a little glue and I'm going to allow it dry a little and I bring them together as you can see. So I just bring them together like that and I use my fingers to press it down to seal that end like this, just to seal the end of the crinoline as you can see. I repeated the same on the other end of the crinoline. So and once that is done, I'm going to be folding the crinoline into two. I'll just fold the crinoline into two and attach my jewelry wire. I'm using the jewelry wire in my own case. It is 0.50 mm. You can actually use any flexible wire you can lay your hands on. This can be gotten from a bead making shop where they sell bead accessories or bead making materials, or you can also get from an hat making shop. I mean where they sell hat making materials. After folding the crinoline into two, I'm going to fix the wire in between the two edges. Yes, I make sure that I cut off enough wire that will cover up my crinoline. Okay, and I use my pliers to do that. I'm just cutting off what will be enough to work with. Now I'm going to fix the crinoline, or I fix the wire into the crinoline like this. The wire is going to be staying in between the two edges of the crinoline. Then I pick my needle and the matching color of thread and I'm going to sew. I'll just sew from one end like that. I sew the wire to the crinoline from one end to the other end. Okay, the wire is sewn to the crinoline as you can see, and the next step is for us to cover the wire with the bias strip. No, we cannot leave it this way. Okay, I just make sure I tack properly like that before I cut off the excess thread. Then I'm going to cover the part with bias strip using my UHU glue. So I'm just covering the part now with the bias strip using my UHU glue, and I'm doing this neatly and carefully so as not to have gum stains. So when you're applying glue to any of your accessory or whatever you're using UHU glue for, you need to allow it dry a little before you go ahead and paste. Okay, now the crinoline is ready and it's time for us to form our spiral shape. No, because of the wire in there, it is flexible. You can always turn your crinoline here and there or form whatever shape you want to form. Okay, I'm just like to do it in a circular way or in a circular form, and I pull like that to form a spiral. And the next thing we need to do is to attach it to our headband. This can be attached to a molded fascinator base. You can always create something really, really nice with a crinoline spiral. You just go ahead and attach it to your fascinator base anyhow you want it. You just have to be creative, you know. In my own case, I'm attaching this to an headband. It's actually for a child, and then I'll be using my needle and thread to do this neatly. The headband I'm using is the iron one, the tiny one, and it's been covered with fabric, and that makes it easier for us to secure our crinoline spiral to it. Now the fabric which the iron headband is covered makes it easier for us. So I'm just tacking it down right there. Then I'm going to be putting my rose and all that to embellish it. You can always add feathers, embellish with whatever you want to embellish with. There are several styles or designs you can create with a crinoline spiral. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you've learned something new. And also, I'll be using this opportunity to inform us I'll be posting other content or other DIYs on this channel. It may actually not be headwear related, but it's just for us not to be bored, and so we can explore and do other things on this channel. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you're here to subscribe, please hit the subscribe button. It motivates me to do more. Thank you so much, and I'll see you in my next video.